I lived in Australia. You know the program I used to like to watch? I used to like to watch the Beverly Hillbillies. And I used to think that was just make-believe. That was something they made up in Hollywood. But that's not true, Freddie. That's how all the people live here, brother. That's what they are. And I used to think that was just total Hollywood, just make-believe. But you people really live like that here. They wear funny hats and they wear overalls when they come to the matches and they chew tobacco. Well, that's fine. Because when you come to see the superstar, you're coming to see class. You've seen the rest. Now you're looking at the best. And wherever you see the superstar's name, make sure he will be there, brother, as I will.
Well, there's quite, let me put it this way. Out of the fans here, I think there's some of the most outstanding wrestling fans in the world are here in Georgia and all over the Southeast. Now, they admire the fantastic ones who've been in your new group and many of the others. In fact, there's going to be some towns coming up I'd like to talk about beginning tonight. Here in Marietta, this coming Thursday night in Gainesville, Georgia, at the Georgia Mountain Center. And next Friday night, July 1st, in Knoxville. Now, you're going to be in those towns. Yeah, and what about those men?
One of them nuts right now. I'm sure you're talking about that Terry Taylor and that Bobby Fulton when you call them a fantastic young
right.
dude. And they are fantastic. Till they wrestle me, I'll take both them guys on. Steve-O, Dutch Mantel, you name it. I'll take them on. And any of the towns that you mentioned, brother, would it be Knoxville or Marietta or Gainesville? I think Marietta tonight, I'll see all you nice people.
See you tonight, Marietta.
Back. One of the X-Men. Right now, catching that big hip toss from the Angel. Angel from France, 260 pounds. He's a tough one, and the former bounty hunter, Gary Novak, at 270 pounds out of Tombstone, Arizona. They're managed by Jimmy Cornette. This tag team would be rough enough, as it were, without Jimmy Cornette. But they got Jimmy Cornette, the spoiled rich kid, as many of the fans have given him the nickname. At ringside, directing his athletes in the ring. Novak in there right now working on Rick Connor. And Jim Cornette is going to join us here at the table.
God, remind these people that when my dynasty is in the ring, performing as only athletes like they can perform, the people should give them the respect they deserve. They're seeing something here in the ring right now that they've never seen before. They should stand up and, as a matter of fact, take their hats off, and the women should curtsy.
Jim Cornette, a little upset over the aggravation being dished out by our fans at ringside. Big back body drop on Ken Hall. The Angel put that man 10 feet in the air. Novak sets that knee, Angel putting him into it. Tag is made. Jimmy Cornette's dynasty, you must give credit where credit is due and give the devil his due. He has got some tough athletes in his dynasty, no doubt about that.
When did this boy get out of the concentration camp? That's what I'd like to know. Huh?
Ken Hall in the ring now, caught in the face lock by Jerry Novak.
He's caught and he's going to stay there. And let me tell you something else. I want you to tell all the people about the Angel's claw hold. I'm sure you'll see it in the weeks and months to come. The claw is without doubt the most dangerous hold in professional wrestling. And the way the Angel does it, nobody else can even come close.
Jimmy, why does he wear a glove on the hand
that,
if it's so
that
good?
That is merely for support, because you see what happened one time when he was applying the claw, he strained the muscles and the ligaments in his hand severely. They've never quite recovered. He can still put on more force with an injured hand than anyone else can with a well hand, but he needs support on that hand. That's why he doesn't conceal anything in it. He doesn't do anything illegal with it, as some people claim. It's there for support. And look at this. They're double-teaming the man. Come on.
Jim Cornette a little upset now because the Angel's getting a dose of his own medicine. Rick Connor whips him into the rope, but the Angel caught him with that knee and the boot coming off. That's what I say about this tag team of the Angel and Jerry Novak. They're rough. They're tough, but when you add the third element on the sidelines, if you will, with Jim Cornette, you're adding another dimension to this team. Big elbow by Novak. Connor kicked out at the count of two. Novak may have pulled him up. Jerry Novak with that big bolo chop to the back of the neck. Angel sets that boot. Big, big right boot into the head of Rick Connor. Tag is made. Angel setting that claw. Connor off the rope. The Angel's got him in that claw. This is what Jimmy Cornette was talking about. The Angel's got the man on the canvas. 2-3. He got a freak out with it.
And that has to come down to this.
It doesn't matter if it was in Marietta, if it was in Macon, if it was Atlanta, GA, if it was in Columbus, it doesn't matter where it was, all them little hearts were fluttering. Well, I'm going to be there in person, folks. Wherever you see Bill Dundee's name, the superstar's name, you can bet he's going to be there. Because when I'm booked Freddie Miller, I show up, and it doesn't matter who my opponent is, I just demolish him. Now, Oh, you little ladies out there, you look at this television screen, I can tell your little heart's just a-fluttering. You'd like to see this guy in person. He's pretty in person as he is in real life. Well, you bet he is. He's better looking in real life than he is on television, and I'll see you folks all over the state. Thank you.
Well, you can find out for yourself when you meet Bill Superstar Dundee. Let's meet Jimmy Cornette and his dynasty of wrestlers.
That's exactly right. Let's meet me. Where did you get that tie, Freddie Miller?
Well,
don't worry about it. The best of world championship wrestling. That's exactly why we're here, because I am the best manager, and these two men are part of the greatest group in professional wrestling, the dynasty of champions that I manage. The Angel, the Man That Doesn't Care, and Jerry Novak, the Bounty Hunter. And whether it be Augusta, Georgia, whether it be anywhere in the state of Georgia or anywhere that we appear, you can be assured of one thing. We are winners. We do win matches. And that's what we're concentrating on right now is the state of Georgia, because we're going to bring you people matches the likes of which you have never seen before. This, the greatest tag team of all time, and this, the most fearsome weapon in professional wrestling, the Claw.
The Angel and the Claw is back, so don't forget it.
Thank you.
Rivers in the ring right now. Fulton is ready for bear, if you would. On Rivers, tag made. Here comes Terry Taylor. The actions of the Fantastic Ones really speak for themselves, because when they're in the ring, they are like grease lightning. Rivers right away getting to the rope to cause that break. Terry Taylor threatening to take the arm right off. Terry's around the head. Now go behind with the hammer lock. Trips him down. Scores the takedown. Puts the knee under the arm. Puts the pressure on. Look at this. Terry Taylor wearing down their opponents very, very quickly in the ring. And these fans really come alive when they see the appearance of the Fantastic Ones. Especially those ladies. The ladies in the arena really like the handsome appearance and the good manners and fast actions of the Fantastic Ones. Pulls it off that middle rope. Across the arm of Larry Hare. Whips him into the rope, catches it, Jim Koss, takedown. Fulton of the Fantastic Ones, a little bit smaller than Terry Taylor. Tag made, here comes Taylor back in. Both move very quickly, and both move well as a team. A lot of teamwork in the ring. Taylor gonna whip Hare again, catches it, big high drop kick off the chin. Taylor goes for the scoop, picks him up, mighty slam, down he goes. Hare, with the wind knocked out of him, needs to make the tag and does so to Dick Rivers. Rivers back in the ring. Go behind by Taylor. Half Nelson flips him over. Grabs that arm, bars it, makes the tag. Here comes Bobby Fulton. Match is one fall, 15-minute time limit. And the Fantastic Ones continue to work very quickly in the ring. Tagging in and out, keeping the action fast-paced. Fulton going to be whipped in the ropes. Rivers sets that block, but then Fulton reversed it. Tag back out to Terry Taylor. Loops him on that inside. Rollover. Head scissors quickly, kicking out of it's Rivers. Taylor maintaining that arm bar. Standing wrist lock. Down Rivers goes. Tag made. Here's Bobby Fulton. Knee across the upper part of the arm. Still working on the left side and the left arm of Dick Rivers in particular. Tag is made. Here comes Terry Taylor. Rivers set up. Taylor delivers. Can you talk about this? Fans at ringside watching very intently every move of the Fantastic One. Step over, loops that leg, brings him across. Fulton gonna tag, referee's not gonna allow it because Bobby was on that bottom rope. Now Taylor moves around, makes the tag cleanly, and in comes Bobby once more. Championship wrestling, come into your hometown, in your area. Get out and see it. If you enjoy the matches on television, you'll for sure enjoy them in person. Bobby Fulton working over that arm, putting the twist to it. Pops down on it. Tag made. Here comes Terry Taylor. Taylor off the ropes. Drops down on the arm. Rivers in trouble. Taylor just pounding down on the arm. Tag back out. Here comes Bobby Fulton, the Fantastic One, showing their teamwork. Fulton catches him with a big fist to the midsection. Side headlock grabbed by Bobby. And caught in the midsection with a big fist. Rivers trying to come back on Bobby Fulton. Fulton being pounded atop the head. Catches one in the midsection. Here comes Terry Taylor. Quickly is Larry Hare to break it up. All four men in the ring. Donnybrook City. Fantastic One's going to whip them together. There they go, and down they go. Fulton whipped into the ropes. Look at this. Slam right onto Rivers. He loops the leg, too. Three, that's it.
That's right. I got many things on my mind, but the first thing on my mind is I'd like to ask somebody something, and that is, Tommy Rich, how's your back feel, Tommy Rich? How does the sting of the leather feel, Tommy Rich? Did you like the sting of the leather as you squirmed on that mat, Tommy Rich? Well, let me tell you something, Tommy. I suppose you're wondering to yourself, what hit me? What hit me? What hit you? This hit you, and then the leather hit you. And let me tell you, Tommy, you keep messing around with Wild Bill Irwin, and you're going to feel more leather than you ever saw in any cowboy show anywhere. Leather all over you, just like white on rice, baby. I'll be right there, cracking and stinging.
Wild Bill Irwin.
Concern yourself.
Count of two.
Instinctive reaction there by Pat Rose. You always want to kick out. This is turning out to be a good match here. Both men the same size. Dundee proving to be the aggressor. Taking the action to Pat Rose. There you go, Pat. Come on, fire back, baby.
Now Dundee coming back on Rose. Rose trying to come up from a knee. Dundee with a boot to the side of the face. Now goes with that chin lock, that reverse chin lock.
You can see Dundee taking the sting out of Pat Rose, though. Wearing him down.
Dundee moving in behind him. Sets that rear chin lock and puts the pressure on, putting that knee right in that back for a little advantage.
This is not really a submission hold, but this is the type of hold that the opponent isn't going to go anywhere unless Dundee wants him to go that way. He'd be setting him up for something. Look at Dundee.
Rose coming up,
yelling at him, chanting at him, wanting him to get up and fight. Get Pat Rose to make that mistake so Dundee can take advantage.
Dundee has turned into a real street fighter in that room.
Just oh, he always has
advantage.
Been. This is a guy that at 15 years old was traveling with the circus in Australia. This man is street smart.
Big back body drop by Rose. He goes for the cover. Got a count of two. Nearly a pin. Rose takes up side headlock on Dundee.
I think that's a mistake now. He's got Dundee a little bit out of wind, but look at Dundee just keep coming right back. You got to stay on Dundee. You just can't sit down in a headlock hold like that. You got to keep the action. You got to go right after him.
Dundee backs Rose into the corner, throws that big forearm again, whips him into the other corner, goes straight into him with the boot in the midsection. Rose reversing it. Dundee going into the corner.
Big boot in the corner. Dundee with the cover.
And gets the three count. Superstar.